Good afternoon to all. Okay, any doubt in last class? No. Okay. So listen properly. This is one of the very important concept in our physics. Conservative force and non-conservative force. Okay. Listen. Conservative force and non-conservative force. Okay. First, before understanding about a conservative force and a non-conservative force, we must know about basic concept. Okay, listen here. First, we must draw a diagram. This is point A. This is B. Okay. This is the earth surface. Okay. Here an object placed at point B at a height h from the earth. Okay, very simplest concept this. So listen properly. This is path 2. This is path 3. Okay, listen. Conservative force, okay? A force is said to be conservative force if work done, that is important. It is simply denoted by caps W. If work done by a force or against the force in moving body, depends only its initial and final position. Okay, not the path followed by the body. Clear? Simply, conservative force is independent of path. Okay, listen. Here, consider one object placed at point A on the earth surface. It is taken to point B by three paths, through first path and through second path and through third path. Straight way, this is second path, this is third path. Okay, what is meant by conservative force? It is depends only initial and final positions of the body. It is independent its path. Okay, so now what is the height of the object h? This is constant. Okay, so the body placed at the point A on the earth, it is taken to point B by three paths. Whatever may be path, okay, work done is equal to same for all paths, because here h is equal to constant. Therefore, work done basic formula mgh. Okay, mass of the object, acceleration due to gravity, height of the object from the earth. Here, displacement and the gravitational force opposite direction. Am I correct or not? So here put negative symbol, minus mgh. Because already we have discussed about basic formula for work done. Listen here. W is equal to FdR cos theta. I am correct or not? Force, displacement. What is theta? Angle between applied force and displacement of the object. Clear? That's all. Then, what is this? Scalar product? No. That means a dot product? No. Therefore, we can written as another formula, basic formula. Initial position and the final position. F vector dot dr vector. Yeah, this is the basic formula. Theta means here, angle between applied force and displacement of the object. That's all. Clear? Okay. Or this formula. W is equal to integral initial position to final position F vector dot dr vector. Because of this is scalar product or dot product. This is the basic formula to calculate work done. Okay. So, what is meant by conservative force? A force is said to be conservative force if work done by or against the force. Work done by the force or against the force depends mainly initial and final position in of the body in moving. That is important. Okay, not the nature of the path followed by the body. Clear? Pora vali eppadi venala irukalam. That is important. Okay, but reaching point is same because of h is equal to constant. So work done will be same for all paths, not a different. Okay, so that is called a conservative force. Then example for this, famous force, gravitational force and elastic spring force. Elastic spring force and magnetic force then electrostatic force. This all example for conservative force, gravitational force, elastic spring force, magnetic force and electrostatic force. Okay, then in considered one dimensional case, maybe along x axis or y axis or z axis, along x axis or along y axis or along z axis, in the case of one dimension, conservative force, it is equal to negative gradient of potential energy. So du by dx, this is the basic formula. Keep note, negative gradient of potential energy in one dimensional case. Okay, along x or along y or along z, that's all. Okay, listen here. So keep in your mind only one word, conservative force, independent of path. That's all. Clear? Okay. Next. Non-conservative force. Non-conservative force. Okay. It is state opposite for conservative force. Okay. A force is said to be non-conservative force if work done by or against the force mainly depends upon its path followed by the body. But here, independent of path followed by the body or nature of the path. But here, slightly entirely opposite for conservative force. Non-conservative force, it is mainly depends upon path. So for different path, value comes different. Okay, for example, frictional force. what? Frictional force or frictional forces. Second, air resistance or viscous force. So this is the examples for non-conservative force, because here you can explain only one for frictional force. Let us consider here one of the object of mass M placed on the surface. When we applying external force on this object, compulsory this object moves with the help of external applied force. Am I correct or not? With the help of F. So here work done against, so here at the same time here one of the opposing force acts between surface and object, that is called a frictional force. Am I correct or not? So here work done against the frictional force depends mainly length of the path followed by this body. So it is mainly depends upon path. At the same time viscous force also, okay, but here mainly independent of path in conservative force. Independent of path, non conservative force mainly it is depends upon path. Okay, clear? Okay, now then we are going to discuss about example problem relevant to conservative force. What is the main example? Yeah, gravitational force is conservative force. Okay, so conservative force mainly depends upon initial and final position of the body in one of the moment. It is independent of the path followed by the body. Clear? Okay, listen. Example problem 4.11. Yeah, just recall in your mind about conservative and non-conservative. Okay, here gravitational force. Yeah, very good. It is one of the conservative force. Okay. For the following case. So here we want to calculate work done by the gravitational force or work done by the conservative force for the following cases. Okay, first, before going to discuss about this, you must know about what is the basic formula for force. Yeah, F vector is equal to ma vector. Am I correct or not? Okay. Then formula for gravitational force, yeah, F is equal to mg instead of a vector, here g, acceleration due to gravity. Okay, and our done, W is equal to integral initial position and the final position, F vector dot dr vector. Okay, keep it in mind. Or W is equal to F dr cos theta. Okay, no problem. Okay, what is theta? Already told you, angle between applied force and displacement of the object. Okay, before that you must know about one small example in our daily life. Okay, small example, that is regarding physics. Okay, what is this? Charge express. Okay, here I am lifting this chopped box like this, lifting here like this. Okay, or this chopped box hanging from my hand. Okay, so with this chopped box I am walking like this. Okay, like this. So here displacement of the chopped box will be like this. Am I correct or not? Gravitational force acting towards down. Okay, here work done by me, am I correct or not? Or work done by you, present or absent? உன்னால செஞ்ச வேலை இருக்குதா இல்லையா? நீ வேலை செஞ்சிருக்கியா இல்லையா? கரெக்டா? Come on, tell me. You வேலை செஞ்சிருக்கியா? சாக்கிஸ் பஸ் தூக்கி போயிருக்கேன் நீ, தூக்கி போறியா? வேலை செஞ்சியா?
சொல்ல வேலை செஞ்சியா வேலை செஞ்சியா செஞ்ச ஹவ் சாக்கி சார் தூக்கி போனியா நோ ஒர்க் டன் பை யூ வை வை யா ரிகார்டிங் சப்ஜெக்ட் ஃபோர்ஸ் ஹியர் ஆக்டிங் லைக் திஸ் பை யூ ஓகே displacement of this object like this both are yeah perpendicular to each other okay perpendicular to each other theta 90 degree cos 90 0 okay so work done by you 0 work done by the gravitational force also 0 Why? Because gravitational force acts like this. Displacement of the object like this. Both are perpendicular to each other. Theta is 0, 90 degree, cos 90 is 0. Work done by you or by the one of the force 0. Okay. Clear? That's all. This one is the simplest example. Okay, listen here. Now, here we want to calculate work done by the gravitational force for the following cases. First, case 1, case 2. At the same time, conservative force, it is independent of path, okay? It is mainly depends upon initial to final position of the object or of the body, clear? Okay, in first case, work done by the gravitational force, come on. First force value, F is equal to ma over k, or effector is equal to mg. X dash Y dash okay here gravitational force acting like this no that force minus J cap okay along negative Y axis okay so here we must consider yeah unit vectors I J cap like this okay so force value minus mg J cap okay At the same time, here we must consider displacement vector also. Dr vector is equal to here two dimension or three dimension? Yeah, very good. X and y only two dimension. Therefore, dx and cap plus dy j cap. Very very important. Okay, this is my. Okay, work done by the conservative force or gravitational force in first case. Okay. W is equal to integral initial to final position effect dot dr vector. Am I right? Very simple. Work done is equal to what is initial position? Yeah. A. Okay. Final position B. Distance between A and B, yeah, H. Okay, so therefore, A to B, force value, yeah, mg J cap. D X or dy. Displacement, very good. dy because of along positive y axis. Okay, so therefore dy j cap. Clear? Okay, so here minus mg dot mo. That is very very important. Scalar product. That means a dot product. J cap dot j cap. Both are parallel, like one or not. So parallel means theta is equal to 0 degree. Okay, cos 0, yeah, 1. Therefore, j cap dot j cap is equal to, we can write as 1. So j cap dot j cap is equal to 1. Therefore, minus taken outside because of this is constant, no? Minus mg from A to B. dy okay so minus mg
integral dx is equal to x, no? Basic formula. So this is equal to y. Lower limit origin 0. Yeah. Upper limit here up to h. Maximum height of the object. Okay. So here you must consider the limits from 0 to h. That's all. So minus mg. First upper limit and the lower limit. So minus mgh. This is the work done by the force along path 1. So P1. Okay? Along path 1. Path 1, that is called P. So path 1 is equal to minus mgh. I already told you small example. Gravitation, simply we can written as or directly that formula. How? Gravitational force acts like this, downwards. Displacement of the object. Okay? Like this. Like or bucket at the steps. Okay? So here work done by the gravitational force on the bucket. What is the formula? What is the formula? Basic formula, FDR cos theta, no? I'm gonna turn here force mg, okay. Dr displacement. It is equal to h. Theta opposite direction. I am gonna turn it. So theta is equal to 180 degree. Cos 180 minus 1. So we can return directly. W is equal to minus mgh. That's all. So that is the work done by the gravitational force on this object. When displacement upwards, so that we put minus because of opposite direction. Force acts like this, displacement will be like this. So both are opposite. So theta is 180 degree, cos 180 minus 1. So work done by the gravitational force on the bucket lifting like this by you, or on this object, displacement like this. Minus mgh. It is equal to this. Clear? That's all. Okay? So this is the work done by the conservative force or gravitational force along path 1. Along path 1. Along path 1. It is equal to minus mgh. Okay? Clear? Okay. So work done by the force. Done by the force along path 1 minus mgh. Yeah, keep it in your mind. Okay, next. In second case, listen properly here. In second case, work done by the force along path 2, A or A, C, D, B, A, B, C, D, or A, C, D, B. So, total work done. Total work done. By the force. Long path 2. It is equal to from A to B, F vector dot dr vector. It is equal to from A to C, C to D, D to B. Okay? Because of conservative force, independent of path, followed by the body or object. Listen here. So, from A to C, F vector dot dr vector plus from C to D, F vector dot dr vector plus from D to B, F vector dot G R vector. Okay. So this is a total vector. It is equal to or will be equal to this one. How? Now only gravitational force, conservative force. Otherwise, we can understand this. Okay. Because now it is equal to this. Okay. So first we want to calculate this. So therefore, listen here. A2C, no? Yeah, A2C. F vector dot dr vector. Already told you. If force acting on the object and the displacement of the object, suppose perpendicular to each other, there is no work done because of 90 degree angle between applied force and the displacement of the object, 90 degree. Work done by the force, zero. Clear? Simple method. Already told you. How will you prove this? Yeah, come on. With the help of direction, first A to C. Listen here. A to C. Force value already written here. Am I correct or not? Mg. J cap. Dot. Dr here. Displacement, listen properly here. Displacement from A to C, no. So along positive x-axis, no. So we must use unit vectors, no. So here considered I cap. Along x-axis. Therefore, dx I cap. Okay. Already written here. I erase it, no problem. J cap dot J cap is equal to 1 because of both are parallel. So here J cap dot I cap, both are perpendicular, no? 0, that's all. Already discussed about this in properties of scalar products, the same unit. Okay, J cap dot I cap is 0. So 0 at anything, 0. So work done by the force along this direction A to C, 0. Okay, from D to B also only direction changes. Here consider minus I, minus and minus plus. Again J cap dot I cap, 0, 0 and anything, 0, that's all. So A to C, yeah, it is equal to 0. It is equal to 0. Clear? What is the remaining? What done is equal to from, yeah, C to D. F vector dot dr vector. Force value minus mg, that means the gravitational force. J cap dot, dot, that is important, dot. Displacement here, yeah, along y axis. So dy, again J cap because of positive y axis. Okay, therefore here C to D, no, like this. Minus mg. At the same time here J cap dot J cap is equal to 1, no? Yeah, therefore minus mg integral C to D dy. So minus mg integral dx is equal to x, no? Okay, therefore integral dx is equal to x. Similarly here y, upper limit, lower limit is 0 because of origin. See this diagram here. Lower limit, this is 0. Upper limit h. So minus mg. First, you should be substitute upper limit h minus 0 and lower limit. So minus mg h. Okay. So total work done is equal to minus mg h in case 2. In first case also, total work done is equal to minus mgh. From this, Yeah, easily we can understand work done by the conservative force. It is independent of path followed by the body. It is mainly depends upon initial and the final position of the object. Clear?